guidance and scientific base and possibility for practical approbation for the results of the research described in Hart's report. Gas turbine engine blades are made of hard to weld heat resistant nickel based alloys having over 6 to 8 thousand operating hours with edge damages up to 6 millimeters deep. So this states a crucial task of reconditioning these local areas up to 6 to 8 millimeters height by microplasma welding deposition. This process developed by Atom Electric Welding Institute has been used for more than 10 years in large scale repair of aircraft gas turbine blade edges. The process is characterized by welding current, lower welding current from 2 to 35 amperes and low heating power of the arc, which provides possibility to make single and modular depositions. The main current problems of microplasma welding deposition are all somewhat affected or do affect the heat input of the process. So the first actual problem is controlling the deposited bead size and form. Since the material is hardly mechanically removed, it is essential to limit the side and upper reinforcements of the welding bead. Also, gas turbine details renovated surface has complex form, which states a problem for controlling the deposition process parameters, mainly arc power and welding speed. The second major problem is that nickel superalloys are prone to micro and macro cracking. They are prone to micro and macro cracks in both fusion welding and in the subsequent post-weld heat treatment. It's widely known that a crucial characteristic responsible for such welded joint technological strengths is heat input in the product. And the third major problem is the quality of additive powder. There is a decent number of quality parameters, such as particle size range, gravimetric content, particle form, powder flow properties, surface condition, powder microstructure, regular defects, and the problem which is described in this report is non-useful adds content, particularly oxygen and nitrogen. The amount of oxygen and nitrogen in additive powder is determined by atomization environment of the vacuum chamber and reliable isolation of atomization chamber's inner space from the outer environment. Then we may see certain removal of oxygen and nitrogen. During the deposited metal crystallization, converts to oxide layer on the bead surface. At the second research phase, we estimated the welding characteristic of JS32 superalloy metal powder with various oxygen and nitrogen contents by criterion of total heat input quantity in the product in one and four layer deposition. The research was carried under previously developed technique for recording and digital processing of welding deposition conditions. The analyzed welding characteristics for metal powder were following: average current value and certain welding current integral per deposition time to a deposited bead length ratio, and effective heat arc power. And heat input. During multi-layer deposition, we additionally defined the total heat input, which specifies energy consumption per unit longitudinal bead length in the workpiece. It was calculated as the sum of heat input in deposition of each layer. We have used two machines for microplasma welding deposition to define quantitative characteristics of heat input in an anode specimen at mono and multi-layer deposition, depending on oxygen and nitrogen content in metal powder. This custom equipment was differed by following characteristics: powder feeding type systems, portion and continuous feed correspondingly, and pulse welding current characteristics, such as pulse current and pulse ratio and pulse rate. Statistical analysis of experimental relation between total linear heat input and deposition height has proved that to create welding joint between layers is required to consume from 350 to 400 joules of energy, thermal energy, and now it can be seen that the condition for ensuring technological strength at multi-layer deposition on narrow superalloy substrate is with respect to constant heat input may be formulated as this formula, where, as we can see, K1 and K2 are coefficients which specify average heat input related to contain of oxygen and nitrogen, and K0 is a coefficient taking into account any possible process technological optimization for multi-layer deposition, such as shielding gas, metal powder fraction, welding mode control, and others. According to the displayed results, we have distributed available additive powder batches according to their content of oxygen and nitrogen. The list of oxygen content batches were named as high quality. They were assigned to the group with the highest amount of operating hours of turbine blades. This batch, this powder batch, contained less than 150 parts per million of oxygen. And medium quality batches have been assigned to group of turbine blades with 4 to 6 thousand operating hours, and the batch of powders which contain more than 250 parts per million of oxygen have been assigned